क्लब फ्रॉम 10th स्टैंडर्ड आई एम स्टडिंग इन सेंट एलिजाबेथ कॉन्वेंट इंग्लिश मीडियम हाई स्कूल यादाद्री भुवनगिरी डिस्ट्रिक्ट तेलंगाना स्टेट टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन द लेसन एसिड बेसिस एंड सॉल्ट्स
हेलो एवरीवन आई एम प्रदीप्ति ऑफ क्लास 10 फ्रॉम सेंट एलिजाबेथ कॉन्वेंट इंग्लिश मीडियम हाई स्कूल
Hello all, as you all know, I am Divya of class 10 from St. Elizabeth Convent English Medium High School.
Hello everyone, I am B. Jahnavi from 10th standard from St. Elizabeth English Medium High School.
Now, let's discuss the chapter Acids, Bases and Salts. Introduction. Acids are the substances that are acidic in nature, which means they are solid taste. Acids turn blue litmus to red. An acid is basically a molecule that can donate H+ ions and can remain energetically favorable after a loss of H+ ions. There are some strong and weak acids. Strong acids like hydrochloric acid and weak acids like lactic acid. Bases are just opposite to acids. Bases turn red litmus to blue. They are basic in nature. They give OH- ions in aqueous solution. There are some strong and weak bases. Strong bases like sodium hydroxide and weak bases like ammonia. Salts. Salts are the compounds formed when the reaction of acids and bases takes place. Indicators. Indicators are the substances that change one color in acidic medium and different colors in basic medium. The examples of indicators are litmus paper, turmeric, china rose and so on. Understanding the chemical properties of acids and bases. As we have already studied about the chemical properties of acids and bases, let's start with
Activity 2.3. How do acids and bases react with metals? This is the activity. Take 5 ml of dilute sulfuric acid into a test tube and add zinc granules to it. Place a rubber cork. Place a delivery tube so that the bubbles will pass through the delivery tube into the soap solution. You can observe some bubbles. Place a candle or a matchstick near the bubbles. You will observe a pop sound. So, this is the activity. Activity 2.4. In the previous activity, we have reacted zinc metal with an acid. Now, we are reacting zinc metal with a base. We should follow the same procedure which we have done in activity 2.3. We should place a few pieces of zinc granules in a test tube and add 2 ml of sodium hydroxide solution because now we are reacting a metal with a base. And we should pass the gas through the soap solution. We will observe some bubbles as the previous activity. We should place a burning candle or a matchstick near the bubbles. Then we will observe a pop sound. This is the activity. Let's see the reaction. Zinc plus NaOH sodium hydroxide in the presence of heat gives rise to sodium zincate plus hydrogen. Activity 2.5. How do metal carbonates and metal hydrogen carbonates react with acids? What happens when acids react with metal carbonates? Sodium carbonate is an example of metal carbonate. Let's perform an activity to find this. Take a test tube with 0.5 grams of sodium carbonate in it. Add dilute hydrochloric acid into it. Take another test tube with lime water. Place a rubber cork and a delivery tube into it. So, when sodium carbonate react with dilute hydrochloric acid, carbon dioxide gas will be formed. You can observe the reaction. So, when acid react with metal carbonate, the reaction is salt, carbon dioxide and water. Then, what happens when metal hydrogen carbonate react with acids? The same reaction will be formed. Let's perform an activity as before. But in place of sodium carbonate, now let's take sodium hydrogen carbonate. The reaction will be salt, carbon dioxide and water. And the lime water will turn into milky white. You can observe the reaction. Do you know why lime water will turn into milky white? This is because of the formation of calcium hydrogen carbonate. Let's see the reaction. Calcium carbonate in the presence of water and carbon dioxide will turn into calcium hydrogen carbonate, which is soluble in water. Activity 2.6. How do acids and bases react with each other? Take 2 ml of dilute sodium hydroxide solution into a test tube and add phenolphthalein solution. Now you can see the solution turns into pink color. Phenolphthalein is an indicator which turns colorless in an acid and turns pink in color in a base. Now add dilute hydrochloric acid solution into the test tube. Now again the solution turns into a colorless substance. By this, we can understand that base is neutralized by an acid. Here is a question for you. Is acid neutralized by a base? Let's add some sodium hydroxide solution into the test tube. The solution again turns into pink color. Now, the answer is yes, acid is neutralized by a base. Now let's see the reaction. When sodium hydroxide reacts with hydrochloric acid, then sodium chloride plus water will be formed. This is a neutralization reaction. Base plus acid gives rise to salt plus water. Metallic oxide is an example of a base. What happens when a metallic oxide reacts with an acid? We all know that when acid reacts with a base, then salt and water will be formed. Let's perform an activity. Take a small amount of copper oxide in a beaker and add dilute hydrochloric acid. Slowly while stirring. You will notice that the color of the solution becomes blue-green and the copper oxide dissolves. Let's see the reaction. When metal oxide reacts with an acid, then salt and water will be formed. When copper oxide reacts with hydrochloric acid, copper chloride and water will be formed. What happens when non-metallic oxide reacts with a base? We know that non-metallic oxides are generally acidic in nature. Let's see the reaction. When base reacts with a non-metallic oxide, salt and water will be formed. Do you remember the reaction that we have done in activity 2.5? We have passed carbon dioxide gas through the lime water. Then the lime water turned into milky white. Here is the reaction. When calcium hydroxide reacts with carbon dioxide gas and will give rise to calcium carbonate plus water. Calcium carbonate is a salt. Let's simplify the equations. When acids react with metallic oxides, then salt and water will be obtained. Metallic oxide is basic in nature. When base react with non-metallic oxides, then salt and water will be obtained. Non-metallic oxide is acidic in nature.
What do all acids and bases have in common? We have already learned that acids are sour in taste and bases are bitter in taste. Both are good conductors of electricity. They produce ions in water solution. Acid release H plus ions and bases release OH minus ions. The process of mixing acid or a base in water solution, it is known as exothermic reaction. Exothermic reaction transfer energy to the surroundings and temperature of the surroundings increases. Endothermic reaction take energy from the surroundings and temperatures of the surroundings decreases. What is dilute solution and concentrated solution? Dilute solution, when a small amount of solute dissolve in relatively large quantity of solvent, then the solution is known as dilute solution. Concentrated solution,
when amount of solute dissolved in relatively large as compared to the quantity of solvent, then the solution is known as concentrated solution. Why don't some acids like glucose, alcohol does not contain electricity? Let us perform activities to know more about that.
We know that acid plus metal give rise to salt plus hydrogen gas. For example, hydrochloric acid plus zinc gives rise to hydrogen gas and plus zinc chloride. By this, we come to know that all acids contain hydrogen. For example, hydrochloric acid, sulfuric acid, nitrate acid. Now, I have a question to all of you. Do you think all components containing hydrogen gas are acidic in nature? To find this, let us perform an activity. Take a beaker, place the rubber core with two nails on it in the beaker. Now connect the nails to the two terminals of the battery through a bulb and a switch. Here, rubber is poor conductor of electricity. Now pour some dilute hydrochloric acid in the beaker and switch on the current. You will observe that bulb will glow. It means that electricity is passing. In place of hydrochloric acid, if you pour sulfuric acid, then also the bulb will glow. Now we will take glucose. Here, why we are using glucose? Because we want to know that compounds which have hydrogen gas are acidic or not. Switch on the bulb. Did the bulb glow? No. Now we will take alcohol. In this case also, the bulb will not glow. It means that these compounds have hydrogen gas, but they are not acidic because they will not dissociate in aqueous solution with hydrogen ion. Take 10 ml of water in a beaker and add few drops of concentrated sulfuric acid to it and move the beaker slowly. Care must be taken while mixing concentrated sulfuric acid with water. After adding concentrated sulfuric acid in water, touch the base of beaker. It feels hot because the temperature of beaker increases. This process is known as exothermic reaction. When concentrated sulfuric acid dissolves in water, it produces H plus and HSO4 minus ions. This hydrogen combines with water and forms H3O plus ions. Add sodium hydroxide to 10 ml of water in a beaker. We can observe that the temperature of beaker increases as sodium hydroxide dissolves in water. This is the warning sign displayed on containers which conduct concentrated acid and bases. Dilution. Mixing an acid or a base in water results decreasing of concentration of ions like H3O plus or OH minus per unit volume.
In the previous topics, we have learned about the natural and synthetic indicators. By these indicators, we can find a solution whether it is acid or base. Now, I am going to explain you how strong are acids and bases in a solution. In the acids, the presence of more hydrogen ions are known as strong acid. Similarly, the more presence of hydroxide ions in a solution known as strong bases. A scale for measuring a hydrogen ion concentration in a solution is called as pH scale has been developed. pH stands for power of hydrogen. Let's have a look on a pH scale.
Here is the pH scale. The pH scale consists of 15 colors, 0 to 14. If the value of solution is less than 7, then it is considered as acidic. If the value of solution is greater than 7, then it is considered as basic in nature. If the value of solution is exact 7, then it is considered as salt or neutral.
pH in everyday life. Just pH only have to do with solutions in the laboratory, or does it also affect plants and humans in daily life? Did you know that when acid rain flows into the rivers, the overall pH of the water reduces and living organisms cannot survive if the change in pH is too much? In such cases, survival of aquatic animals becomes difficult. What about survival of plants? What's the most important factor for the healthy growth of a plant? Yes, it's the soil. Plants require a specific pH of the soil for healthy growth. Plants cannot grow if the soil is too alkali or too acidic. So, if the soil is too acidic, its pH can be raised by adding lye, which neutralizes the excess acid. In the soil, similarly, if the soil is too alkaline, then its pH can be lowered by adding gypsum. Some other substances which can neutralize the excess alkali present in the soil, and does it affect us too?
By now, you should know that our stomach produces HCl acid, which in digestion, sometimes if too much acid is produced, it causes pain and irritation. It can even cause ulcers. In order to treat this hyperacidity, a patient is advised to take antacid tablets or antacids. Suspensions and these antacids neutralize the excess acid. Magnesium hydroxide, a mild base, is often used for this purpose, and this reaction looks something like magnesium hydroxide plus 2HCl gives rise to magnesium chloride plus 2H2O. The acid is neutralized to get salt and water.
What about the pH in our mouth? Yes, the pH in our mouth also has an effect on our teeth. Tooth enamel is the hardest substance in our body and does not dissolve in water and mildly acidic solutions. However, it gets corroded slowly. When the pH in the mouth falls below 5.5, but how does the pH fall below 5.5? When we eat food, some food particles remain stuck to the teeth. Bacteria present in the mouth produce acid. By the degradation of sugar, food particles present in the mouth. This is what causes decaying of the teeth. What's best way to avoid this? We should clean our mouth after eating food, and something even better would be to avoid eating sugary foods. Cleaning the teeth using toothpaste help in preventing tooth decay. Toothpaste are generally basic and hence they neutralize the excess acid in the mouth and prevent tooth decay.
I'm going to explain more about salts. Salts are the ionic compounds which are produced after the neutralization reaction between acid and base. Salts are electrically neutral. There are a number of salts, but sodium chloride is most common among them. Sodium chloride is also known as table salt or common salt. Characteristics of salts. Most of the salts are crystalline solid. Salts may be transparent or opaque. Most of the salts are soluble in water. Solutions of the salts conduct electricity in their molten state also. The salts may be salty, sour, sweet, bitter, and savory. Neutral salts are odorless. Salts can be colored or colorless. Family of salts. Salts having common acidic or basic radicals are said to belong to the same family. For example, sodium chloride NaCl and calcium chloride CaCl2 belongs to the chloride family. Zinc chloride ZnCl2 and zinc sulfate ZnSO4 are said to belong to the zinc family. Calcium chloride CaCl2 and calcium sulfate CaSO4 are said to belong to the calcium family. pH of salts: neutral, acidic and basic salts. Neutral salts: the salts which are formed after the reaction between strong acid and strong base are neutral in nature. The pH value of neutral salts is equal to 7. Example: sodium chloride, sodium sulfate and potassium chloride, etc. Acidic salts: the salts which are formed after the reaction between strong acid and weak base is acidic in nature. The pH value of acidic salts is less than 7. Example: ammonium chloride, ammonium sulfate, etc. Basic salts: the salts which are formed after the reaction between weak acid and strong base are basic in nature. The pH value of basic salts is more than 7. Example: sodium carbonate, sodium acetate, etc. Chemicals from common salt: common salt is sodium chloride. Its molecular formula is NaCl. It is the main ingredient of our food. It is used as a taste of our food and added as a preservative in our food. The following four are obtained from the common salt: sodium hydroxide NaOH, baking soda NaHCO3, washing soda Na2CO3.10H2O, bleaching powder CaOCl2. Chloralkali process: in the membrane cell, the two electrodes are separated by a semipermeable membrane brine, which is sodium chloride or NaCl solution, is pumped into the anode half cell as an electrolyte. The chlorine ions with the brine, which are negatively charged or oxidized at the anode, this converts them into neutral chlorine atoms that bond together and bubble off before being collected as chlorine gas. The membrane only allows the positively charged sodium ions through to the cathode half cell. At this electrode, water is reduced by hydrogen gas, leaving hydroxide ions with the sodium ions that came through the membrane, forming sodium hydroxide and also known as caustic soda. Are the crystals of salts really dry? Let us find whether crystals of salts are really dry or not. Activity: take copper sulfate crystals in a dry boiling tube. The color of the copper sulfate is in blue. Heat the boiling tube and observe the color of the copper sulfate after heating. You can notice the water droplets on the walls of the boiling tube, and also the color of the copper sulfate turns to white because water removed from the salt. Add 2 to 3 drops of water, you will find the blue color of copper sulfate reappears. Reason: water of crystallization is the fixed number of water molecules present in one formula unit of a salt. Chemical formula for hydrated copper sulfate is CuSO4.5H2O. 5 water molecules are present in one formula unit of copper sulfate. Gypsum has 2 water molecules as water of crystallization. It has the formula CaSO4.2H2O. Plaster of Paris: gypsum on heating at 373 Kelvin, it loses water molecules and become calcium sulfate hemihydrates. Plaster of Paris is a white powder, and on mixing with water, it changes to gypsum, once again giving a hard solid mass. Uses of Plaster of Paris: used as plaster for supporting fractured bones in the right position. Used for making toys and materials for decorations and for making surfaces smooth.
Now, I'm going going to conclude our topic. Acid and bases not only takes place in scientific laboratories, they are also present in many places in today's society. Acids and bases are included in our everyday life. In everything from digestion of food to the medicine we take. Acids and bases are also used in cleaning of products that we use daily. Definitely, without acids and bases, the product that we use are useless. Thank you.